Kohima, the land of the mighty Angami warriors, who have resisted the British imperialism in the Naga Hills in the early and late 80s, have gone down in history as one of the most important places, not only because of British occupation of the Naga Hills, but this town witnessed the deadliest battleground ever fought in the Second World War. The Battle of Kohima, also referred as the Stalingrad of the East, was the turning point of Japanese Yugoslav offensive into India in 1944 during the World War II. Kohima was a nerve center of British administration in the Naga Hills. The British have established their headquarters for maintaining an effective control over the Naga Hills, not only because of geographical advantage, but also because the Angami were the first with whom the British first encountered. Most visitors at Kohima stopped to look at the abandoned World War II tank, one of the few remaining mementos from that great bitter battle in 1944. It lies suspended between the National Highway 39 and the residence of the Deputy Commissioner Kohima. This big grand tank fought at the Battle of Kohima, April to May 1941, as part of the 2nd Infantry Division, whose wish is that it should remain where it stands as a permanent memorial to those who gave their lives to the defense of freedom. We are now here at the Kohima War Memorial, which is nestled in the middle of the town, on what was formerly known as Garrison Hill, lies the jewel of the crown, as remarked by the German commissioner on his visit to Kohima, designed as a series of terraces with magnificent stone steps connecting the length and breadth of the cemetery. It bears the testimony of one of the most terrible, close, and bloody fighting in the whole of the Second World War. When the Japanese forces invaded the Naga Hills in April 1944, the Garrison Hill became the chief battlefield of the most ferocious battle fought between the Japanese and the Allied forces. Both sides suffered heavy losses. According to Tasei Toshikazu, a Japanese writer, the Kohima battle was the worst of its kind yet chronicled in the annals of war. Lord Mountbatten, who was the supreme commander of the Allied forces in South Asia, declared, "The Battle of Kohima will probably go down in history as one of the greatest battles." The 31st Japanese Division came to Kohima and reached Kohima on 4th April 1944, and by 5th and 6th April, a division of 10,000 men led by General Sato had surrounded Kohima garrison comprising of 800 assorted British Nagas. For 13 days, the garrison resisted the attack of the Japanese division. The arrival of the 2nd Division of the British Army stationed at Salt relieved the garrison that was almost at the limit of its endurance. By 15th May, the strength of the 31st Japanese Division was broken. During this grim battle, Loyal 8 from Nagas, as traitor bearers, porters, and guides, played an important role. It is believed that 10,000 Japanese soldiers who fought in the battle, only 2,000 withdrew towards Burma. On the 18th plots of the cemetery, there are 1,421 slabs erected in the memory of soldiers who were killed in the Battle of Kohima. Of this, 1,070 were from United Kingdom, 5 from Canada, 3 from Australia, 33 from undivided India, two from East Africa, one from West Africa, nine from Burma, and one non-war British. At the lower end of the memory park, all passersby on the main road can see a monolith in the shape of a traditional Naga memorial stone, engraved with a touching inscription. When you go home, tell them of us and say for your tomorrow, we give our tomorrow.